Good friends, so again we will start the system programming. So yesterday we discussed in previous class the machine architecture, assemblers, loaders, syncers, microprocessor, compilers. These are the part of the particular system programming topic. So we will recollect, we will discuss here what is SSE, what are the different variants of SSE XE machine, and what are the RISC CISC machines. System software consists of a variety of programs that support the operation of a computer. The programs implemented either software and firmware that makes the computer hardware usable. System applications, the text writer, compiler, assembler, loader, linker, debugger, and system software. Then different versions, then machine independent, extra equipment. Then what are the registers, accumulator, index register, linkage register, program counter, status vault. That is the conditional code. What are the different formats, instructional, fetch, decode, execute, then instruction format. So now today we will going to discuss addressing modes. There are two addressing modes available indicated by X bit in the instruction. X represents the contents of register X. There are two things: direct, when the X bit represents 0, the target address will be the address. When X equal to 1, it is the index register. The target address equal to address plus the content of the index register. So we will use instruction format. There are three instruction formats: format 0, format 1, format 2, format 3. We will use different instructions, namely load or store, load accumulator, load into the index register, store into the accumulator, store from the accumulator, store from the index register. Different things we will use here. So formats with respect to the AXL PCST, we will have load instruction and store instruction, stored from the accumulator, stored from the index register. So load into accumulator, load into index register or a linker register. So we have different arithmetic operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. We have different instructions like compare instructions. We have conditional jump instructions. What is this conditional? Based on the status register, we have JLT, jump if less than, jump if it is equal to, jump if it is greater than. Similarly, we have J sub instruction. Probably earlier in previous slide we discussed one thing, J sub. There, probably this and this one, L, this L1, L, this one, and see this part. So linkage L to linkage register J sub instruction. So with respect to the J sub, we will use this jump to the subroutine, placing to the return addressed by J sub is the register, the leak register linkage to L, linkage register. So jump to the corresponding subroutine. You know that subroutine means, so normally in high level languages we will call that as a function or a procedure. So function, we have main program, we have different functions. Like in assembly language programs, we will call all the sub functions as subroutines. So if you want to jump to that particular subroutine based on the condition, sometimes in a loop we want to do some manipulation, then we will check the status flags. Probably we will discuss the status flags after this. So status flags, you know that zero status flag, then carry status flag, auxiliary carry status flag, parity status flag, zero, carry, auxiliary carry, sign is one status flag. So like when we are checking these status flags, there is a need to jump from this particular operation to another. When we want to jump for this, there is conditional jumps, then like a J sub unconditional jumps will be written. So placing the return J sub and return, we will use J sub R sub. R sub is the thing. So R sub returns by jumping the address contained in the register L, so that in the register L we have the where we have to jump this and all will be. So like LDA, we have LDX. Now we have LDL also. What is this LDL? So load linkage register. STA, STX. Like that we have STL also. So store the linkage register. It's very simple. Now load is a particular instruction. Load is from, if you want to get the two things, from the memory to accumulator, from the memory to index register, from the memory to linkage register, this is what load. Similarly, from registers to memory if you want to use, from accumulator to memory if you want to use, then we will use store A. That means the content is available in the accumulator, that should be loaded into memory. Then similarly, if the content is available in the index register, that should be loaded into memory. The content is available in linkage register, that should be loaded into memory. It's very simple. Load, destination, load and store, these are the two particular things. Load and store. In the case of the load, the source is the memory, the destination normally the registers. In the case of store, the destination memory source point is all the register. We know all the arithmetic operations. Like this we have lot of logical operations, like end we have, R we have, XR we have. We will study this. Apart from that, we have IO instructions. IO are performed by the transferring 1 byte at a time to or from the register, rightmost 8 bits of register A means accumulator. Now each device is assigned a unique 8-bit code as an operand. Test devices we will use. Test whether the address device is ready to send or receive. Similarly, we have ready or not ready. Read data, we will use RD. We will use write data, we will use WD. Then, if you, till now we discussed about SIC, Simplified Instructional Computers. Now if you take the SICXC machine architecture, 1 megabytes, 1024 KBs. There we have 32 KB. You see, here we used 1024 KBs. But there in SIC we have only 32 KB. In SIC we have 32 KB. You can see this. SIC we have only 32 KB. The size difference. Okay. Now 32 KB means like this. Like this we have. Then 3 8-bit bytes, this also 3 conjugative bytes, 24 bits. This is what SIC, we are discussing SIC. You see SIC, these are the 0 number, 1 is there, 2 is there, all these things, 0 to 8, these are the things. These are the things are available in SIC. Now if you see the SIC XC machine. Now we discussed now 0, 1, 2. Then we have, see memory 1024 KB. This is 1 megabytes. That's what previously we have 32 KB. Now we have 1046 MB. Now 1046 MB we have. That is point number 1 with respect to the memory. With respect to the memory. So SIC alone 32, SICXC alone 1024. Now three additional registers we will use. One is the base register. This is number is 4. One is the other than base register, we will have S and T. These are the general working registers. So these general working registers will work as scratch pads. So you might studied about scratch pads, probably school children and all, they will write some story or something in a piece of paper and they are throwing, then automatically the content will erase automatically. So that's what working like a scratch pad. So if you do some calculations, next time if you want to be, it should be like a fresh thing. So our writing should be available. So for that matter, these S&T registers will be used as general working registers. One additional registers also used. You see, all BST registers are 24 bits in length, but this F register will be 48 bits in length. So floating point accumulator. You see earlier, if you see the SIC, here the no floating point. So here if you see, no floating point, here no floating point hardware on standard version of SIC. You see here, there is no floating point is supporting, but in SIC XE we have a floating point. So here we are supporting all F register. Its length of 48 bits. Why we required 48 bits? Say if you want to represent a number, decimal values. Apart from that, we have 27.348. What is 24.348? This 0.348 should we want more? That is why here we are using 48 bits in length. Now, so we have three registers. So earlier we discussed the size. So earlier 24 bits, but here there are 48 also, na. So 24 bit binary numbers of integers, two complements for negative bits, we will use data formats. 48 bit floating points will be used. The exponent bit is 0 to 24 itself. Fraction points will represent f into 2 power e to the power of 1024. That's one. 0 set all bits to 0. Now s is exponent and fraction. Now s is set to be 1, then exponent value will be used here, fraction part will be used here. That way we will represent all the floating point data types. Okay, now if you see the SICXE machine architecture, different instruction formats are there. What are the instruction format? Format 1, format 2, format 3, format 4. What is this format 1? We will use only 1 byte. Just now we discussed RSUB. In RSUB means return. RSUB written from the subroutine. So JSUB means we will jump to the subroutine. Once the job over on a particular function performed well, then it is written from back. Say if you are going to your parents home, to from parents home to your relatives home, your mama, chitaba, uncle, what you will do? You will be there for some time, then immediately you will return to your home. That's not the nature, no? Similarly, if you jump to the subroutine, there a subroutine is meant for doing a particular task or job. Once it is over, then you are supposed to be back to pavilion. Then once we enter back, RSUB. So RSUB means we need not mention this is what RSUB, the record address is this one or something. That's what RSUB. RSUB means it is simply 8 bits are required. So we will use RSUB here. It's representing 5 point, just 8, 1 byte, 1 byte, 1 byte. That's what opcode, it's record. RSUB is the best example for format 1. Similarly, we have format 2. 2 bytes will be used here. So in the 2 bytes, we will use 1 8 bits for opcode value, the remaining for registers. So how many registers we have, friends? We have accumulator A, index register AX, linker register L, B, base register, general working registers S and T. So in total we have accumulator, shall I write here? So we have accumulator is one register, we have index register, we have linkage register, we have base register, there are two general registers S and T. So these are the registers. Now we can write opcode comma register R1 and R2 to keep the register number. Now what is this number? Accumulator is 0. What is this number for X? 1. What is the number for L? 2. What is the number for B? 3. What is the number for S? 4. What is the number for T? 5. So like this, if you want to represent a number 0, 0 means the equivalent is 0, 0, 0, 0. What is this one? 0, 0, 0, 1. Similarly, if you want to represent a base register, 0, 0, 1, 1. If you want to represent general purpose register, S, for suppose S. So, 0, 1, double 0. If you want to represent T, 0, 1, 0, 1. Now, the format 2, opcode value, whatever be the opcode value is given, the mnemonic code we will discuss shortly. Then, register, for suppose if you want to write A comma B. For A, we have to use this 4, 4 zeros. B, we have to use 0, 0, 1, 1. Like that, the format 2 will be available. And format 3 or 4. Normally, it's with respect to the address and the displacement. We studied in previous example, as and when we studied addressing mode. Direct one, target address equal to address. If it is index, target address equal to address plus x. What is this x? So, this is the content of the index register. Like this, there are some calculations has to be performed. Now, in format 3 and format 4. In format 3, so we have opcode, then we have N, I, X, B, P, E displacement. Now, if you want to calculate an address of a component, now how we will calculate opcode value? See, here in format 1 and format 2, we will reserve opcode 8. But in format 3, we will reserve opcode just 6 bits. Now we have N, I, X, B, P, E. What is this N? This represents whether it is what kind of depends on the addressing modes. I represents means it's the immediate addressing mode. N represents whether it is a direct or this indirect, like that. So simplified, what is it, SIC or SICC, simple instructions, complex instructions and all. X represents whether the content of the index register will be considered or not. B represents whether the content of the base register will be considered or not. P represents whether the program counter will take care of that or not. E means exponential. Now the point is here. So if you want to get the address of the thing, then we have to get the displacement. Then for suppose if B value is 1, we have to get the content from the base register. If X value is 1, we have to get the content from the index register. Now in time period we will see that XEB is an assured and program counter. So sometimes the program counter, for suppose if you talk about the relocation. So relocation means normally the starting address will be considered as 0. As and when we are updating the program counter, friends, I think you know that the job of the program counter. Program counter, it holds the address of the next instruction is going to be executed by the processor. Now if you have 5 instructions, the first instruction address will be pointed out by program counter. As and when we are executing the first instruction, the second address, second instruction address will be keeping in the program counter. So that's what program counter is also known as, the location counter. So the location counter is keep on updating with the addresses. Now sometimes if you are going with the relocation and all, the program counter job is to update. So when if you start with 0, so in the relocation probably we will discuss later state, but whatever it is, so in later state if you start, assume that everything is 0, then if you get some 4000 as a starting address, then everything should be updated with 4000. So in that context it will be usual. So in format 3, for opcode we will use 6 bits. For N, I, X, B, P, E, we will use 6 bits, 6 plus 6, 12. For displacement alone, we will use 12 bits. So together, 24 bits, we will use 24 bits means 3 bytes. So it is format 1, 1 byte, format 2, 2 bytes, format 3, 3 bytes. Now, we will discuss about 4 bytes. So in 4 bytes, we will use address component. So for address alone, we will use 20 bits. Again, N, I, X, B, P, E, we will use 6. For opcode we will use 6 bits. So now the instruction format means if it is a relative addressing, format 3 will be E equal to 0. If it is a relative addressing, extended address 24 bits, format 1, there E value will be 1. Don't refer memory at all, format 1 to 2. You see here there is no need of memory. Here there is no need of memory. Why? In format 2 we are using only the 2 registers. In format 1 we are not at all using neither registers nor memory, also displacement, so that we need not worry about. So it's very simple. Format 1 opcode, purely opcode. Format 2 will use registers. Format 3 will use displacement. Format 4 will use address component. So this is what the instruction format. Now it's very simple and a beautiful thing. Now addressing modes. Now based on the NIX BPA values in previous slide, wait a minute. So in the previous one we deeply discussed NIX BPA values. You see here. Now we first we will discuss the N component. N is connected with, it's a simple. So if N equal to 0, I equal to 0, we will say SIC, or sometimes for N equal to 1, I equal to 1, SIC. It's for simple instructions, 99% will put N equal to 1 or 0, both 0. Next, I equal to 1, then I equal to 1, N equal to 0, it says that immediate instruction means target address equal to whatever be the value we have. Say we will have an instruction like this, LDA hash 5. So we have LDA hash 5. So but suppose we are writing here LDA hash 5. Now LDA hash 5. What does it mean? LDA hash 5 means LDA hash 5. Load accumulator with the content of hash 5. What is this hash? Immediate. This is the value. So this value will be considered. So immediate instruction. That is the case we have to keep I equal to 1. In the place of NIX BPE, I value we have to keep 1. And second one, indirect. Indirect means N equal to 1. So target address equal to the content of operand. You see, within the parameters, whatever be that there is, we have to. So next one is base relative. These are the addressing modes, friends. Base relative. Then B value equal to 1, P value equal to 0. That means target address equal to content of the base register plus displacement. This is the case, the displacement value will be considered in between 0 and 4095. Similarly, PC relative. So P equal to 0, B equal to 0, P equal to 1. Target equals equal to content of the program counter plus displacement. My dear friends, normally there is no case B value equal to 0, P equal to 0 is okay, but there is no case like B value equal to 1, P value equal to 1, because base address, content of the base register and program both will not be existed at once. So you should be very careful. Sometimes we may put B value equal to 1, P value equal to 1, you should not. Okay. Now, so base equal to mode means P equal to 1, P equal to target headquarters equal to content of the base register plus displacement. Program counter relative addressing mode means B equal to 0, P equal to 1, target address equal to PC plus content of the PC plus displacement. This will be. So now we will see that addressing modes. How many addressing modes we have? Indirect, direct addressing mode. You see, BP both are 0, target address equal to displacement. Index, when x equal to 1, target address equal to old 1 plus content of index register. Index means x, indicate x. Index plus base relative. So x equal to 1, b equal to 1, but p equal to 0. So target address equal to content of the base register plus content of the index register plus displacement. That's why index base relative we are saying. Index register is present, base register is present. That is why b plus x we have to add. Index PC relative, that means x equal to 1, p equal to 1. There is no base, no, that's why b equal to 0. So target address equal to PC plus x plus displacement. Index plus direct, x equal to 1, remaining things b and p are zeros. Format 4 we have to take. In format 4 there is no question of other things. Okay, because format 4 means, you know that format 4 means directly address component is given. So that format 4 means you need not worry. Only E value we have to see whether E equal to 1 or not. We will see that in appendix. If you see this example, normally they are given. This is the memory you might study. This is the memory you might study in other courses. Okay, like computer architecture and all. So what is this 30? These are the address components. These are the values in the memory. Now B equal to 6000. That means the content of the base register is this much. Now PC equal to 003000. That means the content of the program counter is this much. Index register, this is 90. The content of the index is 90. Now we memory addresses 00F. That's what right from beginning this to this they are telling. Now base register content, PC register content, X. Now they are taking some hexadecimal numbers. You see 032600. Now they are decoding this, converting the machine instruction. So now probably you might know this in computer microprocessor interfacing, like MASM, not MASM. If you work with the kit, we will enter like this. This is the hexadecimal code we will enter. What is this 032600? Now what is happening? The machine instructions we are converting. So 03 in binary, 0 means all are four, first four are zeros. Then 30011, then 6, okay, then 2 means 0010, then 60110, then 600, this way. Now what is happening here? Now opcode value is this. Now what kind of format is this? This is clearly the first instruction is format 3. If you say the first instruction is format 3, what is happened here? Format 3, n value, I value, both are 1. So it is a simple. Now we will take that. What kind of thing it is? PC relative. How can we say it is a PC relative? Now it is program counter value is 1. That means X value is 0, B value is 0, E value is 0, program counter value 1. Now displacement value, how much they are giving? This much they are giving. Now how to calculate the target address? So target address in this case, target address equal to whatever be the displacement, this much, okay, plus this much, plus what we are doing. So we have to take the content of the program counter. Content of the program counter, what is there in the program counter? This is what there in the program counter. So that is why 300 plus we have to add this one. How much it is? 600 600 hundreds. Okay, how can we say it's a 600 in hexadecimal? This is called 6, this is called 0, this is called 0. So 3000 plus 600, together we are getting 3600 values. So in this way we will calculate the value loaded into the register. So similarly we will say last instruction. Now this is format 4 03. In the similar fashion we will convert this one 03. Now what is happening here? Format 4 means we have to see ni values both are 1s. X value 0, B value 0, P value 0, E value is 1. Now this is what the address component. Address component, so as it is, whatever it is given, 0, C, 3, 0, 3. So this to be, now what is happening here? E value equal to 1. So we need not worry about base program counter X. Straight away we have to get the content. This one target address is this. In this C303, what is there in C303? 003030, that should be loaded here. This is what the instruction cycle, how it is conversion from a machine instruction to a target address. Thank you very much. So that thank you very much. Okay.